हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम टू योर ओन चैनल मीडू स्टडी। फ्रेंड्स, आई एम योर फ्रेंड आशुतोष फ्रॉम आई एम इंदौर, एंड एज यू ऑल नो, इन मीडू स्टडी वी हैव दिस इनिशिएटिव ऑफ ड्रीम आई एम सीरीज। येस माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन विच फॉर कैट 21 वी आर प्रिपेयरिंग, एंड इन 75 डेज एंड 75 वीडियोज वी आर बिकमिंग रेडी फॉर कैट। ऑलरेडी वी हैव टॉपिक्स videos from multiple sections, and today we will continue. Our today's video is from VA section, verbal ability section. Let me revise you what we have already done in VA. So in VA we have done VA basics 2 video, video number 2 and 15, and in grammar we have 3 videos, 10, 20 and 24. Today's video, my dear friend, is the third video of VA basic, with which we will complete the basic part of VA, and then we will have 2 more videos of grammar. So after that we will have various types of question based things. So let us start today's video and do our part of VA basics. In VA basics 3, we will continue our previous VA basics 2 part. So let me revise you what we have done in VA basics 1 and 2. VA basics 1 was all about the root words. We did some, understood some important roots for cat and understood new words. And in video 2, we learned some new words which can be used in cat, appear in cat in your antonym synonym questions, your paraphrasing questions, or in general also. In today's video also, I will be discussing another set of 35 words. Like in last video, we did 35 words. The idea is to make you familiar with more words, some more usages which can be useful for cat. So let us begin. Our first word for today is parlance, P-A-R-A-L-A-N-C-E. So parlance basically means language typical of an area. So whenever we are going to a new place or we are doing some study related to the demography, this doing the study of language is utmost important. And in such study you will come across the word parlance. Parlance means language typical of area. Next word is parley, P-A-R-L-E-Y. So by the meaning of parley is discussion, P-A-R-L-E-Y means discussion. Parry, P-A-R-R-Y. So parry means to escape or to avoid. So whenever someone does not want to confront and instead want to escape or avoid something, that particular verb for it is parry. Gamut, range. So many times we say na, entire gamut of a particular thing XYZ. So whenever we are using this word gamut, we typically means the entire range. So for good word for range is gamut, G-A-M-U-T. Innocuous, I-N-N-O-C-U-O-U-S. So innocuous, my dear friends, means harmless, something which will not do any harm to you. So you can deal with it without being much cautious, since it is not going to harm. Aspersions, A-S-P-E-R-S-I-O-N-S. So aspersions, the meaning is criticism. Cajolery, cajolery basically means convince. To when you want to convince someone, related to this particular word, convince, another good word is cajolery. So this was our first seven set of words, parlance, parley, parry, gamut, cajolery. In our next set, another set of words, first is eulogy, E-U-L-O-J-Y. So eulogy basically means spoken praise. So earlier, do you know, in times of kings, Raj Darbar hota tha, and then the Raj Darbar, some singer would come and sing the entire the journey, the entire from childhood to the reign to the various victories that king has done. So that spoken praise basically, which is not written but rather verbal, that spoken praise is known as eulogy, E-U-L-O-G-Y. Elegy, E-L-E-G-Y. Elegy basically means funeral song. So the spoken praise eulogy was you are appreciating a live person. Elegy is funeral song, you basically to appreciate the dead. So at a funeral, if you are saying something in a form of song, appreciating the dead, that is basically known as elegy. Satire. So satire, this is a very common word, and many times we say a satirical expression, or today's article in the newspaper is very satirical. So what is meaning of this satire? S-A-T-I-R-E. Satire, my dear friends, mean have some political parallel story to it. So something political story is parallel to it. Instead of giving the exact meaning, you are basically referring to that parallel story. That is known as satire. Next word is veracity, V-E-R-A-C-I-T-Y. Veracity means truthfulness. So whenever you want to be true to a person, truthfulness, that act of being truthful is veracity. Apprehension. Apprehension, another common word, A-P-P-R-E-H-E-N-S-I-O-N. Apprehension basically means anxiety. Apathy. Apathy means indifference. apathetic means you are indifferent, it does not make any difference to you whatever is happening. Apprehended means caught. So the act of getting caught in some matter is basically, for that the word is apprehended. This was our second set of seven words. Let us move to the next set, antipathy. A-N-T-I-P-A-T-H-Y. Antipathy, friends, means negligence, or basically I can say a negative feeling for something or someone is basically known as antipathy. Extort basically means forcefully extract. So forcefully, if you are extracting something out of something, someone, that is basically known as extort. Exhort means to encourage very strongly. Very strongly you are encouraging someone. So just see, these are very, I would say, would sound very near. Extort and exhort, just a change of one alphabet, but their meaning is completely different. One is forcefully extracting and another is encouraging. Repertoire, R-E-P-E-R-T-O-I-R-E. So repertoire basically means where collection is kept. So if I say repertoire of books, what is that? Library, because in library collection of books is there. So repertoire in such as such just means collection is kept. If that collection is of books, it will be library. If that collection is of some other things, it will be some other thing. Repertory, R-E-P-E-R-T-O-R-Y. So that another word of meaning of collection. Vivifying means energized, V-I-V-I-F-I-I-N-G. Whenever we say these things, vivified me, so that means it energized me. Vituperating, V-I-T-U-P-E-R-A-T-I-N-G. Vituperating means something which is harsh or harmful. This was our third set of seven words. Let us move to the next set. So next set, first word is solace, S-O-L-A-C-E. Solace, my dear friend, means peace and comfort, something which is very soothing, comforts you, provides you peace. Intimidation basically means domination, dominating something or someone, intimidation. Vacillation means fluctuation of thoughts. So sometimes it happens that our thoughts keep on fluctuating. Sometimes you are thinking something else, then it keeps on moving to something else. That phenomena, fluctuation of thoughts, is known as vacillation. Next is speed. So celerity, C-E-L-E-R-I-T-Y, speed. Perverted means basically deviated, P-E-V-E-R-T-E-D. Perverted means deviated. Prodigious, P-R-O-D-I-G-I-O-U-S. So extravagant means very lavish, someone who is spending a lot, showing lots of spends, extravagant, lavishness, that is basically extravagant. So another word for extravagant is prodigious. Big or impactful, stupendous, S-T-U-P-E-N-D-O-U-S. So stupendous basically means big or impactful. So this was our fourth set of seven words. Solace, intimidation, vacillation, celerity, perverted, prodigious and stupendous. Let us look our last set of words. Idyllic, I-D-Y-L-L-I-C. Idyllic or idyllic basically means picture perfect, something which is very perfect, or very whenever you are maybe going to some hill station, sometimes we say this is the perfect landscape, I should frame it. Or sometimes it might happen that you are capturing some family moment and someone will say, isko to frame karwa le, it is frame worthy. So picture worthy or frame worthy basically means picture perfect, means idyllic, I-D-Y-L-L-I-C. Imbroglio, I-M-B-R-O-G-L-I-O. Imbroglio basically means confusion. So whenever there is confusion about something, it is basically known as imbroglio. Sophistry, S-O-P-H-I-S-T-R-Y. Sophistry basically means false arguments. So especially in professions like your law, where one of the lawyer has to give false arguments. One will be true, another will be false. And from very beginning, that lawyer will also know. So giving these false arguments is known as sophistry. Timorous. So T-I-M-O-R-O-U-S. Timorous means very shy. So in our friend circle, in family, everyone of us will have one person who will be like very shy, will not mix easily with people and all. So that being very shy is basically known as timorous. Hobson's choice. So see, like in Hindi, one phrase is there, na? Idhar kuwa udhar khai. So means whatever choice you make, it will be bad only. So in English, a very good expression for that is Hobson's choice. All choices are equally terrible. Baleful, B-A-L-E-F-U-L. Baleful basically means malicious. Okay. providential. Providential means fortunate or miraculous. So something which would provide good fortune or kind of miracle is basically known as your fortunate or miraculous. This was our fifth set of seven words. So let us just quickly have a quick revision of the 35 words that we did. Let us go back. So we started with our first set, which was parlance, meaning language typical of an area, parley, discussion, parry, escape or avoid, gamut, range, innocuous, harmless, aspersions, criticism, cajolery, convince, eulogy, spoken praise, elegy, funeral song, satire, has some political parallel story to it, veracity, truthfulness, apprehension, anxiety, apathy, indifference, apprehended, caught, antipathy, negligence or negative feeling, extort, forcefully extract, exhort, to encourage, repertoire, where collection is kept, repertory, collection, vivifying, energized, stupendous, vituperating, harsh or hurtful. Next. Solace, peace and comfort, intimidation, domination, vacillation, fluctuation of thoughts, celerity, speed, perverted, deviated, prodigious, extravagant, stupendous, big or impactful, idyllic, picture perfect, imbroglio, confusion, sophistry, false arguments, timorous, very shy, Hobson's choice, all choice equally terrible, baleful, malicious, providential, fortunate or miraculous. So friends, this was all from today's video, and just like in previous VA videos I have told you, vocabulary has no end to it. See, if you think that by giving you 70 or 100 words I am covering the entire vocabulary, no, it is not possible, not possible for anyone. But I'm just telling you what kind of words you should be careful to, and like previously I told you, spend 30 minutes on reading and 30 minutes on your verbal ability. So in this reading, this online reading will help you for your RC and new words you come across. Even if you do 5 to 7 words per day, you will have good collection for even for CAT and for your entire life, because good vocabulary is something which will help your entire life. In our next video, my dear friends, we will be doing one of the QA topics, which is averages. I hope today's topic is clear to you. In case there is any doubt, you can write us in the comment section, or you can also write on our mail ID midu.study@gmail.com. We will definitely respond to your queries as well as incorporate the feedback. If you are liking our content, please like our video, share and subscribe to Midu Study. Thank you. Take care. Have a good day.